Hi, it's Doug. Have you ever been walking, like in a park or a forest, and you found something that really got your attention? Well, that happened to me recently. I was in a forest, and I found this. It's a pine cone, but I'd never seen a pine cone like this before. I was so curious. I had all kinds of questions. So I came home and I got out some of my books that I have about trees. These books were written by scientists who study things like pine trees. Now, sometimes when I have a question, I find out that nobody knows the answer, and that's always exciting too. But a lot of times, there are answers to things that I'm curious about, and it's scientists who figured them out. Someone named Barina has a question about scientists. Let's give her a call now.
Hi, Doug.
Hi, Barina.
I have a question for you. How do scientists know so much?
That's a great question. To answer this question, it might be helpful to think about what scientists do when they work. Let me tell you a story about two scientists whose discoveries changed the way people think about the world. You see this thing right here? You might know what it is. It's a telescope. And you know what a telescope is used for, to look up at the night sky. But it wasn't always used for that. In fact, when the telescope was first invented, one of the main ways people would use it was to watch for enemy ships coming from far away. No one had thought to point a telescope up at the sky. No one until this person. This was Galileo. He was a scientist. Galileo was curious, and he wondered what he might see if he pointed the telescope up at the sky. One of the first things he decided to look at was the moon. Night after night, he looked at the moon through his telescope. He wrote notes, and he made drawings of what he saw. He was amazed by all the details that he noticed. You see, before Galileo, most people thought that the moon was this round, perfectly smooth ball, more like a beautiful nightlight rather than some actual place. But by carefully looking at the moon, Galileo noticed lots of pointy bumps and shadows. He compared his drawings to things that he noticed here on Earth, and he realized what he was seeing on the moon were mountains, valleys, and hills. The moon wasn't some perfectly smooth light. It was an actual place with mountains and hills, just like the Earth. Galileo realized maybe we could even go walk around on the moon someday. Galileo gave us new ideas about what the moon was really like. Now, here's another famous scientist. Her name was Mary Anning. She's known for being one of the greatest fossil hunters in all of history. Mary spent almost every day of her life, ever since she was a young girl, searching along the beach for interesting fossils. One day, there was a landslide. A huge piece of the cliff near the seashore had fallen down. Mary wondered, "What if I go look over there? If I look carefully, will I find anything new?" Digging through the rubble, Mary noticed some really strange markings in the rock. It was the fossil of a large skull with lots of sharp teeth. As she unearthed the entire fossil and put its bones together, Mary realized that it was the fossil of a giant reptile that had once lived in the ocean. This was unlike any creature alive today. It was an animal that had gone extinct. All her life, Mary kept looking carefully, finding more and more fossils of extinct animals. Mary Anning gave us new ideas about what animals on Earth had been like a long time ago. Mary Anning and Galileo were looking at very different things. But take a moment to think about what their stories have in common. What did both of these scientists do that was similar? Now would be a good time to pause the video and discuss. Okay, you ready? One thing you might have noticed is that both Galileo and Mary Anning started out being really curious about things around them. When they noticed something interesting or surprising, they didn't just say, "Oh, that's neat," and then move on. They noticed things and then paid really close attention. And here's the thing. When you start paying close attention to something, you start wondering a lot more questions. Galileo started wondering things like, "What are those little bumps and shadows? What is the surface of the moon like?" Mary wondered, What kind of animals did these fossils belong to? What does that mean about life a long time ago? You don't have to be a scientist to think like this. This is a drawing made by a young girl named Fiona, who decided to purposely take something plain and ordinary, these leaves, and look really carefully at them. As soon as she started paying close attention, she realized she had all these interesting questions. Drawing and paying careful attention to something is kind of like training your brain to discover interesting new things and ask questions. You should try it yourself. You can train your brain too. For this week's episode, we have a special activity where you'll practice noticing something and asking questions like a scientist. See how many questions you come up with. I think you'll find it's a lot of fun, even if you don't figure out the answers to the questions right away. That's totally okay. Scientists sometimes spend years figuring out the answers to the questions they come up with. Even when you do figure out the answer to a question, you'll find it always leads to new questions. That's actually one of the fun things about noticing something interesting and asking questions. It just gets more and more interesting, and you start having more and more questions. That's why at the end of each video, I always say, stay curious. There are so many interesting things out there to notice and wonder about. There are so many questions worth asking. So in summary, the reason scientists know so much is because they pay close attention to lots of things, and they ask lots of questions. By doing this, sometimes they discover things no one has noticed before. That's all for this week's question. Thanks, Barina, for asking it. Now, for the next episode, I reached into my question jar and found three questions submitted to me that I'm thinking about answering. When this video is done playing, you'll get to vote on one. You can choose from: how do hot air balloons rise? How do trees give us oxygen? Or how close could an astronaut get to the sun? So submit your vote when the video is over. I want to hear from all of you watching. There are mysteries all around us. Stay curious, and see you next week.